Happy morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss illustration number 14 from your textbook. Again, whenever you are going to read the question, they are asking to find out an ideal index number. As per our discussion in the last video, whenever they are asking to find out an ideal index number, you have to be remember we have three type of index numbers. One is last pairs method, other is passage method, and next is Fisher's method. And as per our discussions, Fisher's index number is known as an ideal index number, and the reason behind that, because it is a geometric mean of last pairs and passage index number, and geometric mean is to be considered as an ideal average to construct an index number. So illustration number 14 I have written on the board. As per our discussion, whenever we have to find out such kind of index numbers like last pair, passe and Fisher, always we need four things together: price of both the years, base year and current year, as well as quantity of base year and current years. And one and most important thing, if there is no separate column of unit, means what? The example is very easy and there is no need to equalize anything. But if they have given a separate column of unit, at that time we have to pay more attention to equalize all the units. But for this example, there is no well column of unit. That means what? The things are very easy. We have to just give the notations. See, the base year's price, it is called B0. The quantity of base year is called Q0. The current year's price, it is called P1, and the quantity of current year is called Q1. For this example, they are asking to find out an ideal index number. That means what? We have to calculate only Fisher's index number. Many teachers going to discuss that first you have to find out last pairs, then passe, and use the last formula that Fisher's index number is equal to root of IN into IP. But there is no need to calculate last pair and passe here. We are going to calculate directly the Fisher's index number. So please pay attention over here, Fisher's index number. IF is equal to root of, keep the formula of last pair in your mind, that is sum of P1 Q0 divided by sum of P0 Q0 into 100 we don't write here. Now, passage index number is sum of P1 Q1 divided by sum of P0 Q0. Here also we have to mention 100, but outside the root we use the multiplication with 100. This is the direct formula to find out Fisher's index number without using last pair and passe. So now we need to make four columns, one by one. So first column we are going to make it is P1 Q0, second is P0. Q0, third is P1, Q1, fourth one is P0, Q1. Okay. So now, multiplications we are going to start. P1. Q0. This is your P1 and this is your Q0. 20 into 10, it is 200. 24 into 9, it is 216. 40 into 16, it is 640. And now we take total of that column, it is 1056. Now do next. Multiplication of P0, Q0, you have P0 and Q0, 16 into 10, it becomes 160, 20 into 9, it becomes 180, 32 into 16, that is 512, and again get the total of this one column, it is 852. Now P1, Q1, so this is your P1 and Q1, 20 into 11, it is 220, 24 into 9, it is 216, 40 into 17, it is 680. Get total of this one column, it is 1116. Now P0, Q1. So P0 and Q1, 16 into 11, it is 176. Then 20 into 9, it is 180. 32 into 17, it is 544. And our total of this one column is 900. So these are the separate total of the each columns. Now we have to use such totals in our formula. So now, root of sum of P1, Q0, and that is we have 1056, divide by sum of P0, Q0, we have 852, into sum of P1, Q1, we have 1116, divide by sum of P0, Q1, we have 900, and outside the root multiplied with 100. After solving in calculator, we get our answer at the end, it is 123.97. It is your index number of Fisher. Excess part is always known as there is a rise in price. So right now, -100, that is 23.97%. So this is the simplest way, my dear friends. Keep one thing clear in your mind: whenever we have to calculate last year past sale Fisher's index number, always we need four columns to prepare. Like in this way, we need quantity of base year and current year, we need price of base year and current year, then we are able to get the indices of these different methods like last year, PASE and Fisher's. But only important thing is that whenever they have given a column of unit, at that time we have to be calculate more carefully, because of we have to equalize the limits one by one. Thank you very much.